everybody. Welcome to Caketastic Cakes. It's Jen, and I'm going to show you how to make Jack's Skellington out of gum paste. Okay, just like always, if there's any tools or supplies you see me using that you could use, if you check the link in the description below, it should be able to help you out. All right, it's getting to that time of year, so it's Jack Skellington time. I'm going to start with some white gum paste in his body and basically make a light bulb, as you can see. I have him real skinny at the bottom, nice flare out at the top, and I stuck a lollipop stick down the center of it. These are 8-inch lollipop sticks, by the way. It kind of comes into play later when I make his arms and legs, because I'm going to use those as well there, so just kind of keep it in mind. All right, so that was my white gum paste. Got my light bulb on a stick. Now I took some black, rolled it out nice and thin, and we're going to use that to clothe him. All right, you can see it's a big long rectangle that I made. I wrapped it around it just to get the idea of the size of it. And I did it a couple more times. You didn't need to see it. I just kept measuring it and trimming it off until I got a nice connection down at the bottom where it's skinny, or where his like waist is real skinny, and then it kind of flares up at the top. And you're going to want to leave extra to let it fold over. He has a huge collar that he on his suit, so you want to make sure you leave plenty there for that. I'll show you how to make that in a moment. So once you get a nice length, as you can see, connects at the bottom, flares open at the top, fold it over to get your nice big collar. And I'm using a pair of little scissors that I have to cut a triangle little wedge out of each side. And this is only because his collar is kind of like a suit collar, so it is a suit collar, isn't kind of, so it has the little flare, you know, the little, I don't know, it has a little triangle cut out of it, so there you could see it a little more clearly. Okay, this is going to be his bow tie. This is all black gum paste, by the way, not fondant. I want my decorations nice and firm, so I roll it out kind of the same thickness as his coat, and I'm using the two circle cutters to cut away a top and a bottom niche out of it, my little bow tie shape that I cut out there, to make bat wings. So that way we've got the framework for the bat wings going. I take a teardrop shape, as you saw, pinch it off at the bottom, use my small circle cutter at the top, cut a nip out, and now you got your little bat head. And now I'm going to use my veining tool here, the little very pointy part, to make a couple little ovals kinda, and those are going to be the eyes. I'm going to fill them in with a little bit of white gum paste. And then we're going to put this aside to let it dry. Do not put it on him yet, because we want those wings to stick out. All right, here are my 8-inch lollipop sticks again. I've got a set of them, and I cut them in half, so now they're 4 inches long. And now I'm bending them up near the top. I'm going to bend two of them up near the top and in the middle. Those are going to become the arms. So it's going to poke in at the shoulders, and then the longer parts are going to be the arms. The other two that I just bent in half are going to be legs, and I'm going to show you how I covered them. I took a big old wad of gum paste, black gum paste, kind of like a Tootsie Roll, you know, and just kind of shoved it on in and slid it on up. And it's a huge mess, as you can see. So what I'm doing is I'm pulling and pinching all the extra gum paste into the back of the lollipop stick. So this is going to be his leg, and he's going to be sitting with his legs bent over the side of the cake. So just imagine that. So any type of a seam or anything from all this trimming away that I'm doing is going to be in the back of the leg, so you won't see it. So you just keep working it. Keep pinching it, you know, pulling it gently and trimming off the extra until you get it to a nice thin, real thin thickness, and then stick it on into his body. You can see a little pilot hole there in the picture. On the right-hand side there, inside the torso itself, I just used a lollipop stick and made two little holes just so I had somewhere to stick it. And I just go right into his body. You could try going underneath if you want, I guess, but it kind of doesn't really matter, in my opinion, you know, if you want to, go for it. This is just how I do it. I usually ship these things, so they have to be a little bit more firm and stable. A little bit of water inside the hole and shove it on in there, and now he's got legs. And then you're going to do the same thing again with the arms. You're going to take a big old wad, you know, ram it on in up on your lollipop stick. I leave a little bit at the top, you know, where it's going to go into the body exposed. Pinch it off, pull it off, trim it off until you get it nice and skinny. Add a little bit of water and then press it into place. And just rinse and repeat for the last arm. We're going to take the last arm, cover it with the gum paste, pinch and pull gently off the extra, trim it off, stick it into place. And now we're coming back to our bat. Remember I said to put him aside so he could stiffen up a little bit? Well, now he's ready to go right on his shirt. A little bit of water in the back and stick him on, and his wings stick out so nice, right? I'm doing his shoes. He's got teeny tiny little feet, so I'm just doing a little black drop shape of gum paste and little teeny tiny feet and sticking them in place. Okay, now I added a couple little buttons. It's hard to see, just little black balls onto the front of his jacket to make like buttons. And now I'm going to cover up his neck. I've got my white, roll it out really thin, make a nice little rectangle out of it, wrap it around your lollipop stick. It should have a good amount sticking out the top. And I just squeeze it together in the back and then trim it right there like that with a pair of scissors. So that's my extra. I trimmed down the lollipop stick and I had just a ball of white gum paste. Stick it on the top. He's got his head. Now I'm using my ball tool. I'm using the tiny end of it, or the small end of it, pressing it in and lifting up and around and creating his eye sockets. He's got really big eyes, so, you know, be generous when you're doing it. Using that little veining tool again to make two little ovals, little, you know, slits for his nostrils. And make sure you do them, like, comfortably. You don't want them to be perfect or precise, because that is not how Tim Burton characters are. They are very asymmetrical. So when you make mistakes, they are very forgiving. What I'm working on right here are his hands. I cut out two rectangles and I make four little slices, one for the thumb and then the rest of the fingers. I trim the thumb shorter and I also will trim down the pinky finger, the pointer finger, but I leave the rest kind of long. I put some marks on the back of them, just little lines going across the knuckles to make it more look jointed, like bone fingers instead of straight up fingers. And as you see, I just wrap it around the wrist. Put some water on it, wrap it around the wrist. I have it laying over the other leg just because I have, like I mentioned before, I have to mail this. So he has to be as structurally sound as a skinny little skeleton man can be when you mail him. So I did the same thing on the other side. Another rectangle, cut out the five fingers, make your thumb shorter than everybody. Watch your fingers and everything and then stick it in place. I am now filling in his eye sockets. I have a ball of gum paste, black gum paste on there that I press in and then work around so it actually still is concave. It's not filled in. And I just feel like it gives it a little better, more of a skull look, you know, if it's kind of hollow-ish inside and just dark inside. I also put a little bit of gum paste, black gum paste, into each of his nostrils. And now I'm taking edible food coloring marker and I'm just drawing a big old smile on his face. It's just this really long line with a bunch of little lines going across it to mimic his kind of skeleton teeth. There you go. You see? And again, you want it to be a little wiggly, a little crooked, because that's how he is. Okay, this is the last part. I'm trying to add pinstriping to his suit. I don't have white food coloring paint or anything. So what I do is I use a sharp blade. I'm using my X-Acto knife and I'm scratching the surface. He has sat overnight. He's nice and dry. So when I'm scratching him, it actually makes kind of a white powdery line on him. So you can see I did the veins on the bat's wings and now I'm going around the collar. I'm going down his arms and legs, which is super hard to make straight lines. Go up and down the back, the black body part of his coat. And don't forget his pants. You got to get all around, get as many of them in there as you can. But when you're done, you get a really cool looking Jack Skellington and he can sit on your cake and just be there and be chill. So I hope you found this video helpful. Please like and subscribe. I've got lots of other Nightmare Before Christmas videos out there that you can check out if you'd like. And as always, thank you for watching Caketastic Cakes.